evening, everyone. I believe it's been since last January we were here at the Henley. Was it last January? Incredible. It's great to be back, isn't it? Now, things have changed slightly, obviously. Most of you look better than you did back in January because half your faces are covered. At least that's what I've been told. And we do ask you to wear your mask if it's possible. There are hand sanitizers in the back. Please only use the washrooms up here. Please refrain from licking any doorknobs. We really frown upon that. If you could avoid that entirely, that'd be great. At the end of the service, if we could maybe work our way back from the last row to the front, we'll look at that towards the end of the evening. And those of you who have won door prizes, I actually have your name in my pocket, and they're legible. Some of you will remember that, because Jürgen actually wrote them out. They were computer generated. Those prizes are to my left here on the red table. You can, of course, get those at the end of the night, at the end of the night. And we'll announce those winners at the end of the night. Richard Biega, you're not one of them. I'm sorry. But thank you for the chocolates. You know. It has no doubt, of course, been a very challenging year this year. And I was reminded, I've been preaching through the book of Acts here at Glenridge over the last year. And I was amazed when Paul and Silas, just a quick thought as we open, when Paul and Silas freed that demonically possessed girl, they were not welcomed in Philippi. As a matter of fact, they were arrested, they were beaten, and they were thrown in the deepest prison. You'll remember, of course, the testimony of the Philippian jailer who was saved as a result of their testimony in the jail. But I always found it interesting that despite what happened to them, despite the unfairness of the situation, they sang songs and prayed. This has been a real hard year for many of us. Some of us have lost spouses and have not been able to mourn them properly. Some of us have celebrated anniversaries, significant birthdays. We've not been able to celebrate them properly. We can't even see some of our loved ones for many, many months. My mother can't even come here because, being from Winnipeg, they're in a complete lockdown right now again. But despite all of that, we know God is on the throne, and we can sing praises to Him, just as Paul and Silas did in the prison. So that's what we're going to do this evening. The watchmen are going to come up in a moment, and they're going to sing praises to the Lord. And in your hearts, make a joyful noise. Let's pray. Our loving Father, we thank you again so much for the grace and love and joy and mercy we enjoy in Christ Jesus. We thank you again for the cross of Christ, which so powerfully saves sinners like us, that by your Son we can be reconciled to a holy God. Father, we cry out to you now during these very challenging times. It is a wonder to enjoy some normalcy again, to come together at the Henley, and we pray your blessing on our night tonight and on the watchmen as they sing and praise you, and in our hearts we join in with them. But Father, we do acknowledge the difficulty of this season, knowing that you draw near to us, that you draw us to you because we are your children in Christ Jesus. We thank you for that. And we thank you that despite the wind and the waves, as long as our eyes are on Christ, we know how everything will work out. To quote one of your great servants, Billy Graham, I've read the last book of the Bible. It's going to be okay. So we pray your blessing on our evening in Jesus' name. Amen. The Watchman.
Dedicated to His Majesty from His mighty throne. commandment and decree is to serve Him faithfully. That's the message we must share with all the world today. Oh, we represent the King. He's the reason that we sing. The life we live is dedicated to His majesty. From His mighty throne, He rules by grace alone. We're here to praise His name in everything. We represent the King of Kings and Lord of Lords.
For He shall reign
forever and ever. We represent the King. I sail away, oh, say, but I'm glad. Oh, say, but I'm glad, I'm glad. Oh, say, but I'm glad. Jesus is coming, my cup's overrun. Oh, say, but I'm glad. Wonderful, marvelous love He brings into a heart that is sad. In darkest trials, my soul just sinks. Say, but I'm glad. Oh, say, but I'm glad, I'm glad. Oh, say, but I'm glad. Jesus is coming, my cup's overrun. Oh, say, but I'm glad.
Revelation 21:21, those pearly gates, there's 12 gates made of pearl. We're going to sing about it right now.
And forgive me, oh my sin. Oh, divine, so great and wondrous.
His power to save.
He, the pearly gates will open, so that I may enter in. For He purchased my redemption.
That is a good news story in the times where we hear so much conflicted news. How many of you are glad that the power of God still transforms people and still gives saving grace every day to allow us joy in the midst of the storm? Wow. We are so grateful to be with you tonight. What a joy it is to sing. We have missed being able to get in front of audiences. Like every other major group and minor group like ourselves, we just want to sing. God put a song in our hearts, and it begs to burst. And we just are so grateful for the opportunity to be here tonight. And thank you for coming. And it's an expression of your faith to be out and about. And I appreciate you being here. And we trust that something we say or sing tonight will touch your heart deeply, that God will speak to you and perhaps give you something tonight that you take away that is meaningful in the days and weeks to come. I wonder, when God does something transformative in our lives, and he continues to work in us as we submit ourselves to him, what do people looking on at our lives actually see?
My life to be a light to those around me. I want my life to be a beacon that says hope. I want my life to be a beacon on life's raging seas. I want the world to see Jesus when they look at me.
When the world looks at me, do they see Jesus? When the world looks at me, what do they see? Do they see hope? Do they see love? Do they see charity? When the world looks at me, what do they see?
And when I spoke, did my words contain your wisdom, Lord? And when I prayed, did my prayers contain your love? And did my life reflect the glory of your Spirit, Lord? And did I show to those around you are love?
When the world looks at me, do they see Jesus? When the world looks at me, what do they see?
Do they see hope? Do they see love? Do they see charity?
When the world looks at me, what do they see?
And when the world looks at me, do they see Jesus?
When the world looks at me, what do they see?
Do they see hope, love, and charity? When the world looks at me,
when the world looks at you, when the world looks at me, what do they see?
If you could see what I once was, if you could go with me back to where I started from, then I know you would see a miracle of love that took me in its sweet embrace and made me what I am today, just an old sinner saved by grace. I'm just a sinner.
I'm here to say I'm nothing but an old sinner saved by grace.
I'm just a sinner saved by grace. When I stood condemned, my place. Now I live and breathe in freedom. With each breath of life I take, I'm loved and forgiven. Back with the living, I'm just a sinner saved.
They'd been married for, well over 60 years. Maybe not as old as some of you, but they were old. But the time finally came, as it comes for all of us. And, well, it was Henry's graduation day. And he moved on up to glory. Oh, my. Ethel missed him so. She just missed him so. And sometimes this is the way it works with old couples that have been together for years and years and years and years. It wasn't long, and it was Ethel's graduation day. And she met Henry, and he was showing her around, and she was absolutely blown away. Just, oh, look at over here. Oh, she says, and I feel so good. And she says, I know. No more of those aches, pains. And look at that. Oh. And she was just overwhelmed. And finally, Henry looked at her and said, honey, just think. If it weren't for you and your stupid vitamins, we could have been here a lot sooner. You know, we try to hang on a lot, don't we? But oh my, that first, when we first step into heaven, it's a great, great, it will be a great, great morning.
Well, it's a great, great morning, your first day in heaven when you stroll down the golden avenue. There are mansions left and right, and you thrill at every sight, and the saints are always smiling, saying, how do you do? Oh, it's a great, great morning, your first day in heaven when you realize your worrying days are through. You'll be glad you are not idle, you took time to read the Bible. It's a great, great morning.
Well, I had a dream, and I'll confess I hated to await.
Dreamt he was an angel at the great pearly gate.
St. Peter said, why, hello there, where have you been?
We've got your mansion ready, so go in.
And then he rang for an angel to act as a guide.
He spread his wings a time or two, and they're not
fine. Oh, it's a great, great morning, your first day in heaven, when you stroll down the golden avenue. Mansions left and right, and you're thrilled at every sight, and the saints are always smiling, saying, how do you do? Oh, it's a great, great morning, your first day in heaven, when you realize your worrying days are through. You'll be glad you were not idle, you took time to read your Bible. It's a great morning, a great morning. What a happy day.
Well, I woke up this morning feeling fine. I woke up with heaven on my mind. I woke up with joy in my soul, 'cause I knew my Lord had control. Well, I knew I was walking in the light, 'cause I've been on my knees in the night. And I prayed till the Lord gave a sign, and now I'm feeling mighty fine.
Well, I'm feeling mighty fine.
I've got heaven
on my mind.
Don't you know I want to go?
I want to go.
Yes, I want to go.
Where the milk and honey flow.
There's a light that always shines.
That always shines.
Down inside,
this heart of mine.
I've got heaven on my mind, and now I'm feeling mighty fine.
I've been walking with Jesus all the time.
We're walking and talking as we climb. We're traveling the road to the sky, where I know I'll live when I die. He's been telling me all about that land, and he tells me that everything is grand. And he says that a home will be mine, and now I'm feeling mighty fine.
Well, I'm feeling
mighty fine.
Mighty,
yes, I'm mighty fine.
I've got heaven
on my mind.
On my mind.
Don't you know I want to go?
I want to go.
Yes, I want to go.
Where the milk and honey flow.
Milk and honey flow.
There's a light that
always shines.
Down
in this heart of mine.
This heart of mine.
I've got heaven on my mind.
Heaven on my mind.
And now I'm feeling mighty fine.
Well, I'm feeling mighty fine.
I've got
heaven on my mind.
Don't you know I want to go?
I want to go.
Yes, I want to go.
The light that always
show of hands, how many people know about, if you may not meet him, but Bill Gaither? How many know about Bill Gaither? Yeah, well, most of you do. Well, Bill's been a pretty prolific songwriter, and we like a lot of the songs that he sings. But we have a songwriter in our group, right over here. Tim wrote this next song, and it was for the dedication of a church in Kitchener. Did I say it's Bethany? Where are you? Bethany Missionary Church. Tim and Jackie have just moved back to Kitchener, and they're attending Bethany Missionary Church once again. But he wrote this song many years ago, and it's a wonderful song. We're going to let you hear it.
Much you care. We set our hearts, O Lord, to do your will. Open our eyes and stop our ears, our vision fill.
And he said, I will build my church.
Worship and share my story. Yes, I will build my church.
A shining light for you and a beacon clear. Over the years, dear Lord, you've seen our joy, our tears.
Come fill our hearts anew with holy awe. As we exalt and lift Jesus high, your people draw.
And he said,
I will build my church. I will make it strong. I will manifest my glory as you worship and share my story. Yes, I will build my church.
Very much to be Spirit-led.
Forgive past failures, Lord, reveal your ways. Our hearts we humbly yield to you now, we give you praise.
And he said, I will build my church. I will make it strong.
I will my glory as you worship and share my story. Yes, I will build my church. I will build my church. I will make it strong. I will manifest my glory as you worship and share my story. Yes, I will my church. I will build my church.
Go ahead.
Out of his great love, he picked me up, set my feet on a sturdy rock. Out of his great love, I've learned the meaning of salvation. Out of his great love, out of his great love, he picked me up, set my feet on a sturdy rock. Out of his great love, I've learned the meaning of salvation. Out of his great love,
I've gone astray, I lost my way, when I called upon his name, then he rescued me. Now the song I sing,
what a loving God is he. Out of his great love, he picked me up, set my feet on a sturdy rock. Out of his great love I've learned the meaning of salvation, out of his great love.
Now I'll shout his praise through all my days, for his endless mercy and grace. There's another one who has greater love.
With joy I will ever say, out of his great love he picked me up, set my feet on a sturdy rock. Out of his great love I learned the meaning of salvation, out of his great love. Out of his great love he picked me up, set my feet on a sturdy rock. Out of his great love I learned the meaning of salvation, out of his great love. Out of his great love he picked me up, set my feet on a sturdy rock. Out of his great love I learned the meaning of salvation, out of his great love. Salvation out of his great love. Salvation out of his great love.
Amen. Amen.
Say something. I need some breath. There, talk about that.
We are so grateful for the wonderful truths that we know. I've often said to people over this last 6 months or so since COVID took a swing at us, isn't it great to be a believer? Isn't it great to be a Christian? Because we have hope, and it really doesn't matter what's going on around us. There's a little bit of political friction in the U.S., I understand, that's intensifying in these hours. In Canada, it's not much different in many circles. There's a lot of people upset, fearful, angry, moved by fear. I'm so glad to live by faith. I'm so glad that in the midst of being careful, in the midst of being cautious, we have assurance and hope that no matter what happens, great things lie ahead for each and every one of us. Incredible things, marvelous things. Oh, what hope we have, what joy we have concerning our future. I am so, so very grateful for that. Well, we want to sing about that. There's a song that we've sung probably, I'm guessing, yeah, it's been 50 years we've been singing this song, but yeah, it's a funny thing about this song. It gets more real and more precious as we get older. Listen to the words.
There's a city that looks o'er the valley of death, and its glory has never been told. Where the Lamb is the light in the midst of the night, in that beautiful city of gold.
Where the sun never sets,
and the leaves never fade,
never fade,
and the righteous forever will shine, shine like the stars in that beautiful city of gold. There will be no more sorrow, pain, sickness, or death, and the saints, they will never city where there never comes a night, in that beautiful city of gold,
where the sun never sets,
and the leaves never fade,
oh, never fade,
and the righteous forever will shine, shine like the stars in that beautiful city of gold. In that beautiful city of gold.
This is a song you know, it's not new. For a long time, but oh, how we love and only love more as we get older, to talk about God's faithfulness and His grace, to tell the story. Of our Lord Jesus Christ. Our pastor at Bethany started a new series on grace this morning. It was a blessing to hear just some of the highlights that are lying ahead for us in the next number of messages. How many of you have experienced grace in your life? You know that if it wasn't for the goodness of the Lord, where would you be? I find it hard to imagine that a 16-year-old's going to Eastwood Collegiate in Kitchener, attending Bethany Church, part of a youth group, part of a ensemble choir group. We were asked to form a quartet for a Bible College talent contest in 1968, 53 years ago. God has been so faithful. He's been good to us, and we love Him more. We love to sing about our Savior Jesus more, and we love living in grace.
Calvary and I love being forgiven, and I'm living in grace. I will never have to pay the ransom for my sin. Jesus reconciled me when he died and rose again. So I will serve him daily as an
songs. We're just going to take a couple minutes to do a couple of things right now. One is just to let you know, we in case you didn't know, we have some product you might be interested in. You know, Christmas is coming. Oh, brother, just about came today. Anyway, so on our side table here, we have 10 different CDs. Three of them are instrumentals. One of the instrumentals, Brian got the best instrumental album of the year by the Canadian Gospel Music Association. The rest of the ones, all the rest of the seven, they're all vocal singing. One is an a cappella group that Tim was in a part years ago, many, many years ago. He actually sang with his son.
With my son.
With his son, yes. Reporters, yeah. But the rest are the Watchmen songs. And so the way it works, what we got here is if you want your choice, one, it's $15. Or any three of your choice for $25. Or any, if you want the whole shoot and match, all 10 of them, it's for $50. You get a bag.
And,
but, yeah, and if you buy anything, go ahead, Tim.
You get this amazing DVD for free. It's called The Atheist Delusion, and it is an absolutely masterful apologetic argument for the gospel of Jesus Christ and the reality and the truth behind it. Ray Comfort speaks to university students, largely. There's a few others, but mainly university students, many of whom claim to be an atheist. And he dismantles for them in a loving, kind way the argument that they make that there's no God. And by the end of it, many of them are just sort of, oh, yeah, I guess there must be a God. It's a wonderful DVD. You get that free if you buy any of our product at all. Now, I want to talk just for a moment about something that is near and dear to many of your hearts here at Glenridge. You have an author among you. Her name is Kay Yonsey. She knows this guy quite well, and for a long time now. And Kay has been writing personally and privately for many, many, many years. And just a few years ago, she started to put her thoughts together for this first book, which has won over 5 major awards, the top gift book in its category, and every picture that's in the book she took. She's an amazing photographer, nature photographer, and people as well, but just wonderful photography, but the prose, the words, they have impact, and they're anointed. And it was Lorna Duick from Huntley Street that said, doesn't matter what page you turn to, just pick it up, and it will bless you, and you will find that it touches your heart on the day that you happen to read that page. And so that book was a real blessing, and it's just not where she stopped, and she keeps on writing. And this one came out before she ever knew that COVID was going to strike in May. She wrote Safe in a Hard Place. I believe that is her granddaughter on the front cover. It is just amazing. I read this book in one sitting from front to back, and I was blessed and encouraged with the message that it carries to buoy your spirit, to lift you up, to encourage you. No matter where, again, you pick it up and read, the words are a gift from the Lord. And Kay has really been sensitive to listen and to put those thoughts down on paper. You will be blessed if you get them. The books are $20, and we have them at our table as well. Dave, I think your wife has a table set up here
her books on it. Yeah, she's here tonight, and if you want a book at all and you want her to sign it, she'll do that. And I'll just add an added thing. The second book has been a real surprise because it just came out in March, and so she just found out the end of March that, I don't know if some of you are familiar with Mom's Choice Award, but they're a company down, they're an organization down in Virginia, but they take products. They're not a Christian company, they're a secular company, but they take products from over 55 different countries, thousands and thousands of products, but they awarded her a gold award level on a Mom's Choice Award, which is as high as you can get. So we were just thrilled with that. And so anyway, the sticker, the sealer, is the seal's there. And so come on, have a look and say hi to Kay. And she carries on conversation. You wouldn't believe the way she talks. If you know my wife, you know that's not true. All right, that's one thing we're going to do. The hour's going quickly, but we only had two songs left, so we have to fill it somehow. No, that's not true. We do have only two songs left. However, we want to take just a few minutes. And actually, this came as a request from the chairman of the board of the church. These are difficult days. For some people, they're more difficult than for others. But I'm sure you might be one of these people, or maybe if this doesn't apply to you, you might know someone. We hear about people that are afraid. Maybe you're very fearful of the unknown. Or maybe you know somebody that is just right now enslaved by fear. You know? People used to come up to me and say, do you know anybody that has COVID? And actually, the truth of the matter is, there's a group that we've had here in this very church on more than one occasion. They're from Rochester. And they actually sell Kay's books as well. But they were down the States, and they placed an order. I came through to Kay, and we said, well, we thought you were on tour. He said, well, we were. But all three of us have COVID. And Final Harvest. Maybe some of you remember the ladies, Final Harvest. Some of you might be ill. Maybe you know somebody that has COVID. Maybe you don't. But maybe you have some other physical problems, challenges. I know some of you do. I know you do. Some of you are waiting for reports, medical reports. Some of you have had medical reports. Some of you are going in for more testing. So maybe this is the category that you either are going through right now personally, or you know somebody that is near and dear to you, and they're going through that right now. Maybe some of you know people who have experienced a lot of loss, maybe financial loss, maybe businesses that are going down, closing up. Maybe you've got loved ones that have lost, maybe because of depression, maybe because of death, already alluded to by Tim. People that are gone, and you can have a funeral the proper way, or maybe some kind of isolation so that you're really feeling alone and wondering what to do with the moods that you have, can't sleep. Well, so this is a strange season. But I'm so glad that the Lord Jesus, nothing has caught him off guard. And the thing is, he knows and loves every single person in this room. And all those dear ones that perhaps, well, I've been listing a few things you've been thinking about. I just read a part of a book that Tim gave me from his pastor. And he was talking about when he was a little boy. And he said, I didn't need a message. I needed a miracle. I needed a miracle. The beginning of Kay's second book, she puts as a topic page, she said, faith still believes in miracles can happen. Faith still believes that miracles can happen. So I guess what we're going to do just for a couple minutes, and then we're going to sing our final two songs. If we've itemized something that is pressuring on your heart and your mind, we're going to have a prayer time. I'm going to ask in a minute, I'm going to ask Pastor Tim to come just lead us in a prayer. Not a long prayer, but a prayer for you. Or if you know of someone that is going through terrible things, what I think would be really, really great is to have those of you who perhaps even know someone who is not yet a Christian. Oh, he's not yet a Christian. She's not yet a Christian. She's close, but they're so lost. We're going to just have those of you who wish to and are able to, just to stand where you are as Tim comes and leads us in a prayer. And we're going to ask the Lord, the God of miracles, to give peace to those who need peace and comfort, to give healing, to give peace of mind, to give fellowship for those who are lonely, those that are tears because of loss, whatever they need. We're going to ask the Lord to do a mass wonderful miracle in our midst here tonight as we sing and worship him. That's what worship means, giving God worth. Well, he's a God of miracles, and he's a God of love, and we're going to intercede tonight just for a moment of prayer in this worship night. So if that's the case, wherever you are, just stand up right now, before Tim leads us in prayer. Or if you are someone or you know someone, stand up. And the rest of the guys, we're going to put our hands out just like this and ask the Lord to do a work of grace just as you're standing. Tim, would you lead us, please, brother? Thank you.
Thank you for the privilege, Lord, of this great gift that you have given to your church, to your people of prayer. We're the people who have all the problems, all the needs, and you are the God who has all of the resources. And nothing is too difficult for you. You have proven yourself faithful time and time again, and you've told us that our eyes have not yet seen, our ears haven't heard, nor has it entered into our imagination the things that you have for those who trust you, for those whose eyes are fixed on you. We choose in this moment to fix our eyes on you. And Lord, we thank you that you've invited us to cast our cares on you because you really care for us. We do that right now. Lord, for those who have a face swirling in their head and mind right now, of someone they desperately want to see reconciled to you. They want to see them come to Christ. They want to know that they're part of the eternal plan of salvation that you have. As those faces and names come before us in this auditorium tonight, we ask that you would honor the promise of your word, that you will save those who cry out to you. Whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. We pray that you would move upon their hearts, break through whatever darkness and fog and haze and the deceptions of this world that need to be burned through with the glorious light of your life. We ask for great salvation stories to be coming in the very near future. Lord, there are those among us tonight who need a physical touch. And God, you have proven to me again and again, it is always right to pray. We don't control the outcome. We can't make it happen. But it is always right to pray. And thank you for the many times you have amazed me with a miraculous reversal of the natural order of disease or sickness by bringing healing. And we ask, Lord, for those in this auditorium tonight, you know who you are. You have aches, you have pains, maybe something much more serious. And tonight, we are believing together in the powerful name of Jesus, who shed his blood on the cross, and who by whose stripes you are healed. Lord, we ask for a miracle, and we ask for miracle stories to come shortly. Lord, for those who need reconciliation with others, there's walls between, there's broken relationships, and I'm sure that there are some parents and some children and some grandchildren here tonight, and they're grieving because it isn't just COVID that keeps them separate. Lord, we ask tonight that you, who are the Prince of Peace, who breaks down every wall, that you would enter the situation and that you would bring restoration and reconciliation to those relationships. Lord, we just pray that you would hear the cry of our heart. There's other things that I can't think of right now and don't imagine, but Lord, there's not a detail that you don't understand fully. So I pray right now that you would come and meet those deep needs of the heart. We give you praise. We give you thanks for what you will do. We believe that there is power in the name of Jesus. Can I hear an amen on that? There is power in the name of Jesus. We are trusting you, Lord. Our eyes are fixed on you. We know that we can't do anything, but you sure can do everything. We praise you. We give you thanks for what you will do. In Jesus' name, amen.
You may be seated. Thank you very much. All right.
He's the same God yesterday, today, and forever. We talked about his faithfulness earlier. Listen to the words.
Yeah.
gone through loss. Some of you may have people who are on the other side, and you're looking forward to meeting them. I come in tonight. I mentioned to Jorgen that I miss not seeing Keith Lichty here. What a dear brother and a friend to the Watchman for so many years. How many of you have people that have given you a great investment in heaven? You're looking forward to seeing people again in heaven, people that you love, people that you care about. Well, friends, the good news is this. Homecoming day is coming, and we will see Jesus, the greatest thrill. And I believe by many different indicators in Scripture that we will see people we've known and have renewed sweet fellowship that stretches into eternity. How great is that? Let's sing it.
I know you're weary from the battle, but you've never faltered by the way. There is a promise that will help you to go on. Soon it will be homecoming day, when the Father calls to take us home to stay. Homecoming day, when the waiting is over.
say, welcome home, my child.
Homecoming day, when the waiting is over. Homecoming day, all these earthly trials are through. Heaven will be worth it all. Soon we will hear the call that tells us this is homecoming day. Heaven will be worth it all.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Watchmen. Let's give them another big round of applause. I think they might be around for a while. They're pretty good. Now, you do have some envelopes. Please feel free, as the Lord leads, to give an offering for the Henley tonight on your way out. As we make our way from the back to the front, listen very closely, as I tell my children. Listen closely. We want to work our way from the back to the front. On your way out, we're going to be using these side exits. Do not use the main doors in the middle of the auditorium, please. Please use the side doors. You can drop your offering in the baskets. They're at the back on the table. Now, when you pre-registered, your name was put into the computer. And we have 8 door prizes that were generated. I had nothing to do with it. And I found it interesting that the very first name, Jürgen did it, the very first name to win a door prize was Bobby Halleck. He then redid the computer, so I win nothing. I have in my pocket the door prize winners. Now listen very closely, because the prizes are on the table here. If you grab the wrong prize, the other person might tackle you on the way out, and it'll be messy. So please listen very closely for your name and your prize. I will leave this list on the table just in case you forget. Our first winner since coming back from 75 years ago, Catherine Keating. Where's Catherine Keating? You have won a book, a dictionary. No, I'm just kidding. You won Safe in a Hard Place. That's your door prize, so make sure you grab that on the way out. Our second door prize winner, Hugh Rogers. Hugh, you won a Paul Bellacci CD, Our God Saves, from Heritage Christian Bookstore. Joanna Pyle, you have won a new car. No, I've always wanted to say that. You have won just as good, Little Thoughts for Big Days, that book. Don Wilson. Hey, you have won a CD in the garden. What was the name of that CD again? Correct. Elaine Reimer. Elaine Reimer, you have won a Henley water bottle. William Wright, you've got a Henley t-shirt. That's four, right? You can get it, make sure you get a good color. James Arthur. Jim. You've never looked so good. You got a CD, The Watchman, Homecoming Day. And last but not least, Kathy Hills or Halls, Jürgen? Okay, same thing, Hills or Halls, it's all the same. You've got the DVD, The Atheist Delusion, an excellent CD, excellent CD. That concludes our night. Please, again, if you have won door prizes, make your way up in an orderly manner, grab them and go ahead and make your way out. We're gonna leave from the back to the front, but before you go, let's close in prayer. Our loving Father, we thank you again for this night. We thank you again for the grace that we so richly enjoy in Jesus Christ. We thank you that despite the difficult times that we've endured over these last few months, we know that you are seated on the throne and nothing comes across your divine desk and surprises you. That you are a God who is in control of all things, and all these things are being worked out for a glory beyond anything we can even imagine. We have a great future and a wonderful hope in Christ in the heavenly places. We thank you for that wonderful promise and truth that one day we will be with you always. And even now you are with us to the end of the age. Bless us as we make our way out, giving you all the praise and glory. In Jesus' name, amen. It's good to see you. Have a good night.